Hi, my name is Francois Therrien, and I'm a researcher here at the Royal Tyrrell Museum of Paleontology. Today, it is with great pleasure that I present you new research on the feeding behavior and bite force of two species of Tyrannosaurs, Albertosaurus and Gorgosaurus. Here at the museum, we're lucky to have a very good fossil record for these animals. We have a full growth series for these species, going from individuals that were about 3 years of age, 6 years of age, 11 years of age, and then all the way to fully grown adults at over 20 years of age. So by looking at the jaws and the teeth of these animals, it is possible to reconstruct how feeding behavior and bite force change during the lifespan of those species. So by looking at the teeth and the jaws, I was able to determine that the feeding behavior of these tyrannosaurs did not change during their lifespans. Their jaws were all adapted for biting and holding onto their prey, regardless of age. And that makes sense because, as you all know, tyrannosaurs have very short forelimbs, so they could not use their hands to grasp their prey. So they had to use their jaws to do the dirty work of capturing, holding, and killing their prey. But if you look at their teeth and their bite force, you see a dramatic change during the lifespan of these tyrannosaurs. In very young individuals, we have very weak bite forces, typical of other theropods of the same size, and their teeth are also very blade-like, just like any other theropod. But starting at the age of 11, then we see the teeth become much more robust, fatter, just like the typical Tyrannosaur teeth, and their bite force start increasing dramatically, increasing exponentially, to such an extent that in fully grown Tyrannosaurs, their bite force is greater than that of any known theropod, including the giant Gigantosaurus. All these lines of evidence tell us that these Tyrannosaurs underwent what we call a shift in their diet. In very young individuals, these animals probably fed on small prey, but starting at about the age of 11, the same size as the gentleman behind me, when the animals reach that size here, that these animals develop these strong adaptations for powerful bite and for crushing bones that allows them to tackle large prey, such as duck-billed dinosaurs and horned dinosaurs.